Why would you expect an engineer to do a manager's job? Speeding up a process is way more effective than changing it. It's very important for microservices to understand the context in which they will be used. Knowing the boundaries and the context of the application is critical. Tech teams compare microservice architecture to a magic wand. One touch and everything will work as it should. All features are available, errors are cleared, and the working speed is increasing. I often hear managers and project leads using this term, but less often do they focus on business processes. Let's talk about it today. Hi, I'm Andrew Putin, and today I'm going to talk about microservices. For a while, I didn't know how to avoid using technical terms when approaching businesses, but I finally figured it out. Microservice architecture begins with the concept of bounded context. First of all, it is very important to define it properly. That is what I will try to do today using some simple examples. Let's imagine that we have two departments, accounting and sales. First of all, let's define what is bounded context. It's a certain set of values sharing a single domain model when applied in a specific framework. In other words, it's a common slang. For example, the term product has different meanings for our sales and accounting departments. In accounting, a product will be defined by an article and a price. For the sales department, the meaning of a product will be more customer-oriented. For example, a certain model of sneakers, even if it has different sizes, will be considered as the same product. Now let's imagine a construction company with hundreds of employees and as many different accounting and payment processes. In this case, it would make sense to have separate teams of accountants doing different tasks such as reporting, issuing income tax statements, processing salary payments, and revising disputes. Each team has its own team lead and its own organizational processes and procedures. The only thing they don't have is that much needed translation between different contexts. At some point in time, the accounting department will become a large division with lots of specialists performing different tasks. Every accountant will have the same definition for the terms sales and product, not needing an interpreter. Definitely, there'll be a need for new communication processes between the different teams. It's one thing when a few specialists take care of the whole accounting, and completely another when you have a bunch of accountants doing one task and another bunch doing another task. Large departments do require additional financing. However, since our accounting usually works with huge amounts of incoming requests, the administration costs become reasonable. Besides that, the chief accountant has a clear need to follow all company procedures and to allocate the responsibility areas. Because even if a couple of specialists are not very busy, the financial losses are very low considering the huge budget of the whole accounting department. Moreover, these specialists won't get any extra tasks from the other teams as they have their own processes, procedures, and team leads. Now imagine that you don't have this amount of workload for each micro task. Your department is much bigger than needed and you don't issue hundreds of income tax statements daily. Let's say that a few specialists could manage the entire department, but financing would be the same, as if you would have hundreds of accountants. Since the entire accounting team is small, the operating processes between departments are disrupted. The specialist who used to work with disputes yesterday processes payments today and will do reporting tomorrow. Of course, the chief accountant will want everybody to be in different teams and to have different functions. But since all teams are basically formed by the same people, the communication processes will also be disrupted. According to company procedures, once a letter is ready to be sent, it has to be registered. Once it is received, it should be registered again. Will this procedure make any sense in a small accounting department? Why would you register a document sent from the payroll department to the reporting department if in fact it's done by the same person?
That's really bullshit.
Let's make it even worse. Imagine that your accounting is a mess. No one knows how to process salaries, reports are submitted via Excel, and payments are calculated manually and processed with errors. It's clear that the problem is in the lack of procedures aimed at solving routine tasks. It's an organizational issue. Meanwhile, your chief accountant has read somewhere that creating micro departments is the way to go. This great model has it all covered and is very easy to scale. It's easy to understand who's responsible for what. Isn't it great that instead of cleaning up the mess in your work processes, you just create a brand new structure of micro departments and just sit there waiting for a miracle to happen? Will this segregation solve the problem, considering that in first place no one has ever defined work procedures for processing payments or submitting reports? Instead of figuring out what is wrong with your processes, You just create new ones, making it even worse, because new problems just add up to the old ones. At the end of the day, the chief accountant will quit and get a new job in another company, spreading their success story about innovation and micro departments. By the way, that's how Facebook works. Notice anything similar? Unfortunately, that's how most IT businesses are managed. However, IT systems usually evolve faster, and therefore their lifetime is much longer. Instead of growing organically following the company needs, instead of sorting out business processes and delegating system changes, engineers integrate microservices everywhere they can. In the long run, you get an IT system looking like a microservice, considering how much work was put into it. But the outcome that you get out of it is not at all what you expected.
Moreover, it doesn't even solve any of the problems, because your problems are organizational. Why would you expect an engineer to do a manager's job? If business processes are not clearly defined at the very start, you won't solve any problem by organizing the code. Speeding up a process is way more effective than changing it.
Once you learn how to build processes and design service maps, most speed issues will disappear. It will become clear what kind of logic the code is using, meaning that your software will work faster, because all the issues will be dealt with in a secure and reliable way at the early stages.
I'm not trying to discredit microservice architecture. What I'm trying to say is that if a software is working slowly, if you're having trouble supporting it, and if new features are not being developed fast enough, microservice architecture won't make things right, just as the right screwdriver won't sober up a drunken handyman.
It's very important for microservices to understand the context in which they will be used. A microservice must receive something clearly understandable to operate with and give out something clearly understandable to everyone within its context.
Its own understandable context is formed by a set of services, meaning that multiple microservices are able to communicate with each other within the same context. It can be a messenger, for example. If one microservice addresses another one directly and uncontrollably, then you will get a monolith.
When you change one piece of code, you'll need to check the other pieces. If the service performs a very common task, then usually it communicates with the world in a passive mode. It expects to be contacted by an API and it has its own context.
Let's say you're using a clutter code address classifier in logistics. As soon as this microservice receives a new address, it identifies it and applies the clutter code following its own logical procedure. Other microservices won't even realize how this information got there. Even though all microservices operate in the same context, they're only aware that there should be an address and there should be clutter codes. Now imagine that you have a cloud service, Dadata, for example, which also knows how to match clutter codes with addresses, but it has its own API and its own expectations regarding the context, which are common for different types of users. That's why this service will have its own context.
This means that data won't be considered as a microservice because it's a major application, even though it's organized as a microservice.
What will happen if the context of the microservice architecture is not clearly defined? For example, both sales and accounting departments have the same context.
Each microservice expands logically, taking into account more and more processes and messages that may interfere with each other. The same action can be done differently for various departments, making logical concepts become vivid. This makes the development of microservices very complicated and testing even harder. The organizational monolith will either surpass your microservice or transform them into a monolith, leaving only shadows of certain microservice features.
Instead of solving global tasks, engineers are busy making sure that everything is working. Their brains are not being used as intended, but are consumed by routine service operations. It's not unusual to see an urgent need for microservices among developers who get wound up in the organizational mess while they spend most of their time checking for system errors.
And the negative selection of developers also shouldn't be ignored. The best will get fed up and leave. Knowing the boundaries and the context of the application is critical. Moreover, not every context must have a microservice structure. If a company is monolithic in its organizational structure, meaning that different functions are mixed up within departments, the used service will also become monolithic. Therefore, it is useless to make any architectural decisions until all the management issues are solved.
Tech teams often advise to allocate some parts into separate services, trying to fix their current technical problems.
Managers should help them by correctly assigning responsibilities. To do this, business processes should be gathered correctly into unified context, and information must be properly delivered to technicians.
If this is not done, any system will eventually become a monolith. Sorting things out properly makes the life of technical teams much easier, increasing their work satisfaction and speeding up process changes by implementing new functionalities, not in a non-stop mode, but based on clear and often unified metrics and business processes.
That's it for today, and next time we will talk about business process modeling. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.